Hello and welcome, myself Rehan Ali, and today in this tutorial I'm gonna show you how can we print these triangle patterns. So without any further ado, let's get started. So here also this pattern is very similar to this one which we already had solved in our previous tutorial. Only this extra part is there because here in both of these patterns we have the same requirement or the same feature, such as in both of these patterns we need to print the same number of stars in each row. For example, for this first row 7 stars are printed, as you can see in both of these patterns. Similarly, for the second row 6 stars are printed, and for the third row 5 stars are printed, and so on. Therefore, the code that we had written in our previous tutorial for printing left-sided triangle, we can use that similar code here too. We just need to add this extra spaces part only. So let's see how can we do that. Here in this pattern, for the second row 1 space is printed, and for the third row 2 spaces are printed, also for the fourth row 3 spaces are printed, and so on. You may notice that for the first row there is no any extra space. So for printing spaces before printing these stars, we can use one another for loop as like this in our previous code. Now we have to run this loop different number of times for each row. So as you can see, for the first row this loop will not run, and for the second row this loop needs to run one time, and for the third row it should run two times, and so on. So for this purpose, first I'll use one temp variable and assign this to value 0 as like this, and increment this value by 1 each time here. So for the first time when this loop will run, as temp value is 0, this loop checks whether call val is smaller and equals to temp. Here this condition will return false, as call val 1 is not smaller or equals to value of temp 0. So only this loop will run first time. Then after printing these 7 stars, we are incrementing this temp value by 1. Now for row val 2, again we check whether call val is smaller or equals to value of temp. This time condition is true, as 1 is smaller or equals to 1. Then we print this extra space and then increment this value by 1. Now call val is 2. Again condition will return false because temp value is 1 here. Now we again print these 6 stars and increment this temp value by 1, and doing the same things, and so on. Means for the third row this loop will run 2 times, and for the fourth row this will run 3 times, and so on. If you are unaware of working with the for loop, you can watch my first tutorial of this series where I have explained all about the loop and also written our course for printing different types of square patterns. Alright, so run this code and see the output. Here it is, we get our intended output printed. But here we can also use some other condition to avoid using of this extra temp variable. We'll use our numrows and row val for this purpose, as like this. Let's first run it to see the output. We get the same output as before, but this time without using any extra variable. Let's see why these conditions work. Here for the first row, row val is 7 and also numbers are 7. So when we subtract this row val from the numbers, we get 0, as 7 minus 7 is nothing but the 0. And this is the value that our temp variable was also containing for the first row. Now after printing first row, as this value is decrementing, now the value of this row val is nothing but the 6. Again when we subtract this row value from our numbers, we get 1 this time, as 7 minus 6 is nothing but the 1. And in this way this condition is sufficient to print these spaces as we needed here. So now as we done with this solid pattern, we'll see our next pattern. So now for printing this hollow pattern, we have our conditions as like this. Means we have to print stars only when row val is equals to numbers, here it is 7, and when call val is 1, because each time this call val is starting from 1 only, and the last one this value is same as the row val. As you can see here, this row val and call val is always same. Means when row val is 6, this call val is also 6, and when row val is 5, this call val is also 5, and so on. So these are the conditions that we need to print this hollow pattern. Now let's write them in our code. Now run it to see the output. This output is nothing but hollow triangle pattern. Now let's see how can we write our code to print this last pattern. Here also, as we already had used this condition to print these lines, Those are nothing but odd numbers of rows such as 7, 5, 3 and 1. So we can use this extra condition in our hollow triangle pattern to print this last pattern as like this. So now run it, and yeah, we printed the last pattern of this tutorial. You can download the source code of these patterns from the link that I have provided in the description of this video. Thanks for the patience. If you like this tutorial, please click on the like button and share it with your friends. Also subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to never miss out any incoming videos like this one. And that being said, see you in the next video.